everybody's, our police department. Ready for the professional fights. 5 minute rounds. It's do or die, baby, do or die. Did I mention my buddy John, and he likes Converse. Shh, don't talk about John. Beyond the fold, beyond the fold. Shh. Don't say beyond the fold. Ladies and gentlemen, presented by Rojas Restaurant, where you can bring your ticket stub in and get that complimentary margarita. Who wants a margarita? I'm buying. Let's do it. Free tickets, you're in. Let's go. 185 pounds in this title match. Titles are over, right? Pro fight. That's better. Thank you, buddy. Fighters, are you ready? They ready back there, baby? Well, too bad, because we got to start this show. People want to see it, right, Pueblo? From Colorado Springs, Colorado. He is the CFL's 2010 Knockout Artist of the Year and Team Wildman Fighter, Jeremy the Grizzly Kimbo! Going against this man, right? first fight from Dallas. And now, out of the notorious B1 MMA, Rio Rancho, New Mexico, please welcome Martinez Chico Young! Take your ticket stub in for that complimentary margarita. Rojas Restaurant. Working harder as the clock tick tock. Reaching for the tip top main. I'm trying to have my empire bigger than bones. With the rest going hard and go home. Bad knuckle boxes, baby, hard and those bones. I came from the bottom, look how largely I've grown. You can get torn all apart in my soul. So once I hear a bell, keep on, it's on. I told y'all to leave me alone. I'm crazy like A.A.
Artina Chico Young!
You guys hear it any better over there? Can you hear us over there? All right, good. They're deaf. They're deaf. Fighters, we're going to take you to the center of the ring for instructions.
Okay, gentlemen, we went over your instructions in the locker room. I want a good, clean fight. Obey my commands at all times. Obey the rules at all times. Protect yourself at all times. Any questions here? Any questions here? Touch them up, come out fighting.
Fight fans, the rest of the bouts on the card this evening are in professional division. Our first professional bout pits our fighter out of the red corner, Jeremy Kimball. He's representing Team Wildman, wearing the black and pink and landing a leg kick.
And he's going up to see blue corner fighter Chico Young, the Strike Force veteran, originally from California, now fighting out of Jackson's MMA in New Mexico.
The last three or four times I've written articles about Mr. Kimball, he's won knockout of the night. He's turning it into a habit and a good one at that. Jumping roundhouse kick lands well, but Young fires back strong with punches.
In fact, Kimball's last three fights, all TKOs in under 1 minute.
And again, the jumping roundhouse kick by Kimball.
Not looking to rush things here. He's looking to set things up. Both fighters being patient, looking for their opportunity.
Solid inside leg kick by Young, answered with a teep from Kimball. Swinging for the head kick as Kimball just barely grazed off the brow. Nice count punches landed by Young. Kimball tasted those.
Had some pretty good head motion, was able to minimize the dips from those, but going to have to keep those hands a little higher if he wants to go later into the round. a reminder to our viewers at home in the professional ranks here, we got 5-minute rounds. Knees to the head are legal.
If you're standing. Each fighter able to land solid shots on the other, neither letting it show. Nobody looking rocked so far. Kimble takes a hard shot there and just steps forward through it. Now Young staggered just a little bit. Kimble saw that too, and he closes in. There's the knee you talked about, Alex. And Young starting to show that those punches are getting to him. He's staggered, Doc.
He's thrown a couple nice knees in the clinch, Kimble has, and he's starting to hurt his opponent.
Young going into a bit of survival mode, swinging now. And one more time, Kimble goes for the jumping roundhouse. Oh, but a counter right by Young. Lands solid, knocks Kimble down. But see, Young lets him off. I don't think Kimble's hurt here. Bit of a flash knockdown.
Yeah, he got kind of flash went down, ready to pull guard, just kind of regrouping himself. You'd think the Young either want to take advantage of that or get Kimble back standing, not let him have time to adjust and recuperate from that shot.
Although Young may be recovering himself.
Good point, JR. Both these fighters landing solid shots. Look for Adam Martinez to bring both fighters standing here if nothing happens.
Doesn't take the crowd long to voice their opinions about what they want to see happening. And that's exactly what they're looking for. Stand and bang, toe-to-toe. And the head kick lands for Kimble. Young takes it well.
Kimble, with a more traditional martial arts background, tends to come in at some unusual angles. Looked like a little bit of a groin strike accidentally there by Young.
I was thinking that as well. Seemingly unaffected by it, however. Once again going high is Kimble. Nice fake with the leg kick to set up the takedown. He has both legs, gets Young to the ground.
That really was beautiful, JR. He faked the outside trip there, used it to secure a double leg and a takedown, but Young able to get back to his feet and reset.
Well, there's a reason these guys are professional fighters, and the skill that they're showing right now is the reason for that. Very entertaining first round here.
A little bit of a question mark, a Brazilian kick there by Kimble.
Kimble lands with the jab, steps out of range of the counter punch.
Kimble looks to be leading with kicks and countering with punches.
Solid right hand by Kimble. He knows that he's hurt Young again. Young content to let his back be against the cage here. That's a dangerous place for a closer like Kimble.
Well, Young's got his hands and he's against the cage, maybe doing a little bit of rope-a-dope.
Driving for across the cage is Young. However, he's met with counter punches by Kimble. And the knee by Kimble. There's 10 seconds left. Kimble looked like he was going to set up the takedown. Young immediately positioned himself to defend it. And that was an entertaining number one.
Really a phenomenal first round by these professional fighters. Majority of it on the feet, striking. I would have to give the 10-9 nod unofficially there to Kimble. He was able to do more shots, although there was that one single shot by Young that dropped Kimble momentarily. Overall, a great round. We see here on the replay some nice counter punching, some in and out punching, some nice unorthodox leg kicks by Kimble, and really entertaining striking round. Neither one of these guys really wanting to leave it up to the judges. They're out here throwing down, wanting to end this fight on their own terms. We see that short little left that dropped Kimble there. No real long-term damage. We'll see if that was enough for the judges to give it to Young or whether they'll give the nod to Kimble. And we prepare here for the start of round two.
Well, I'm looking down at my notes, and they're covered with blood, so you know it was a good first round. You talked about Kimble leading with the kicks. He does just that to open up round number two.
Young shakes his hands out, looking to get his rhythm back, looking a little head motion, get back in his rhythm for round two.
We always talk about fighters from out of state. how's their cardio going to be when they come to altitude, but the Jackson's guys train in a pretty high altitude themselves. Young fires off solid. Kimball rushes him across the cage. And Young lands a shot that puts Kimball on his back. He's flurrying with a finish here. Kimball trying to regather himself.
Kimball able to pull back into guard. That was definitely the best shots of this fight. Kimball was hurt. He's able to regroup, looking for a little bit of a lockdown, looking to get his marbles lined back up here, JR.
This is the best opportunity of the fight for Young so far, and Kimball is shutting him down. Good overhand right landed on the ground there, Young, however. Kimball working the wrist control, wants to shut down that ground and pound.
Around the ground here, and Young, a very seasoned and experienced fighter, all of his wins and losses, either by decision or TKO, has no submission decisions or ends to any of his fights. Kimball, when he's gone through submissions, they've been losses, all his wins by TKO. So being on the ground, kind of a different experience for him, but he's doing a nice job of neutralizing Young and taking the moment to kind of regather himself.
We can see from here the forehead face of Kimball starting to look a little bit battered. He's cut over the left eyebrow, but it's not really bleeding very much. Maybe it's more of a scrape than a cut.
It's going to turn into it if Young starts to land some of those nice elbows that he's throwing there. Kimball getting off on a hip, looking to set up maybe a little bit of a Kimura or Roman Plata there. Back into guard. Adam Martinez telling the fighters to get busy or they're going to be standing.
You're doing a good job of shutting down the submission attempts of Kimball. However, once he's back into a safe position, he's not popping his arms free to land the ground and pound like he'd want to do from this position. And looks like Young is going to let Kimball back up. He's standing and threatening to strike, but he doesn't look like he's really wanting to close in.
Right as he started to close in, Kimball threw a nice up kick. Kind of backed Young up there. Now referee Adam Martinez brings it back to their feet. The crowd appreciated that.
So are we, because it's been the striking throughout the entirety of this fight so far that has been very entertaining. Guess you'd call that a swing and a miss.
Hey, Kimball starting to swing from outside, not setting up with those leg kicks like he was effectively earlier in the fight. Goes for a spinning back kick there.
Bit of a capoeira move busted out here.
Kimball's corner begging him to stick with the basics, telling him you don't need to be fancy here. You've been doing well on your feet. Stick with it. Good defense. Don't expose yourself with any crazy moves.
Young fakes the overhand right, Kimball takes the right, closes in for the takedown, snatches him off the cage and puts him on his back. Young trying to pull himself into the cage so he can get his back there. Unable to do so, Kimball has one hook in and an arm around the neck.
Looks to sink his left hook in. Young shuts that down, Kimball comes back down. He's going to have to open up some space with some strikes there.
Corner of Kimball, and they want him to work. Don't slow it down. Oh, and a good knee to the body by Kimball. Very intelligent striking by the Colorado fighter.
Young kind of turtled up here, looking for an opportunity to escape. Kimball just staying on him, looking for small shots, really looking to sink those hooks in still.
Kimball doing what he can to slide the left leg through. Young keeping his defense tight on that side. Kimball still has the hook in on the right. Less than 30 seconds left in round number two. Let's see if Kimball's able to close off the submission. We heard the 10-second clacker. We're going to get treated to a third round in our first professional title bout, or not title bout, excuse me, but our first professional bout of the evening.
And an excellent second round again. Very close, going to be a tough round to judge. Kimball got dropped by a couple shots early in the round, but last minute of the round secured a beautiful double leg, had a nice takedown, was able to get a dominant position as Young was turtled up. but wasn't able to sink the hooks in and finish it. We see here that nice short left hook to drop Kimball. Starts a little ground and pound. Kimball was hurt there, recovered well. Very smart move to kind of get his position back. Looking at both corners here between rounds, Dare, I've got to say, Young, looks like the altitude is getting him. He's breathing hard. He's having a hard kind of taking his time on the stool. Kimball listening to his coaches. Battered and bruised, definitely beat up, but ready for round three. Adam Martinez starts the fighters, and we're off for round three. Little touch of the gloves, show of respect. Both fighters circling. Kimball kind of pawing the jab out, just looking for range. And leads with those kicks. Needs to follow those kicks up with some hand shots, though. Nice double leg. Pushes Young up against the fence. Able to start lift him. Nice underhook by Young to neutralize that shot.
Now Kimball drops down low. Tried to go for the ankle pick. Unsuccessful with it, so he changes levels as much as he can and goes for a knee to the face. And Kimball complaining about something to the ring. I think maybe he was saying Young was holding his shorts.
Veteran move by Young. If he did, he did it on the side opposite where referee Adam Martinez could not see. Kimball switches to the single leg. Really good down defense here by Young. A lot of energy being dispelled by Kimball going for this takedown against the cage.
We'll see how that plays out in the latter half of this round. As you alluded to, Young was looking a little bit weathered as they went back to their corners from round number two, but we don't know how much energy Kimball has lost there.
Nice thrown in the clinch there by Young. The fighters break. Kimball wiping up from his nose, pulling the hair out of his face, ready to bang.
Almost always, it has been Kimball that has initiated the action. Young has been very solid with his countering, but not often have we seen him press forward. Young sets his feet, again looking to counter strike. Kimball uses the range to land a solid low kick.
Well, JR, when you've got a fighter tired like Young, Kimball really needs to take advantage by leading, and his corner is imploring him to be off first and drive this fight forward.
And Kimball just misses with the Steven Seagal kick. Now Young presses forward. However, it's one shot, then he drops his hand, circles off. Crowd letting these fighters know they want them to press the action. It's easy to fight from outside the cage. I'm undefeated from behind my microphone.
And both fighters trading single shots and then separating here. Neither one of them really wants to engage in a lot of combinations or go into the clinch here. Nice lead right by Young. Just misses the mark. Again with the kicks by Kimball. He's leading with those kicks. I'd like to see him follow up with his hands.
Agreed, especially when Young has his back against the cage where, you know, all I can do is take a lateral step one way or the other. The corner of Kimball. Team Wildman fighter Thomas Denny saying, finish the war, finish the war. He wants him to get after it. And he does just that, closes in for the takedown. Nice job of spreading his feet apart by Young. Kimball switches on to a single leg because of it. And he's able to scoop the foot out and get Young to the ground.
And again, Young starting to turn his back a little bit here. Kimball actually having his opponent against the cage, a hindrance at this point. Can't slide his right leg in to get the other hook. May want to pull him off the cage and actually pull him back onto his back.
Looking to flurry with strikes. Wanting to close out this round. There's about a minute left. Round number three. Starting to loop the arm through. Trying to set up the hand position is Kimball. Young, however, defending with one-on-one wrist control.
Well, peppering shots from the top there on Kimbo, looking, working both hands, looking for the opening, just needing, looking for space. He's got to get in there. He's got to finish this fight.
He has room to slide that right hook in now. If he elects to do so, he's a little bit out of balance toward his left-hand side, is Kimbo. But I think he's going to be content to finish the round in a dominant position, landing strikes. That'll win the round for him, almost assuredly.
And we see here the 10-second clacker, a little bit of a back out there by Young, but Kimbo going to finish in the dominant position. Looks good for the judges.
We'll let Barona give us the score. Alex, break down the last round for us before he does so.
Another good last round, mostly on the feet. Pretty even in striking in that round. Neither fighter was hurt with punches or kicks, mostly peppering shots. Kimball, definitely the aggressor with the shots, although he only secured one takedown. When he did, he was able to take Young's back and dominate the rest of the round. We see on the replay here, nice little kick there by Kimball. Fighters kind of reset, and again, that round was more 1-2 shot, reset, 1-2 shot, reset. Judges tabulating their scorecards here. You know, you got to get a lot of respect to both fighters here. We've got Chico Young coming from out of town, veteran fighter, he goes the distance. We've got Kimball, who in his last three fights, like I said, under a minute. He's won them all by TKO, but no one's really driven him deep into a fight. He did well in that fight. So, you know, whoever wins this fight, that was very entertaining. It was a good war, good for the fans. I'd love to see either one of these guys fight again. We'll throw it up into the cage for Buzz Corona to give us the official decision. We see both fighters there talking, touching up gloves, probably going to have themselves a brew later. Lots of respect. Got to love that in this sport.
Brittany Milka in 15.
I wasn't able to punch you into unconsciousness, so I'll shake your hand instead.
Happy birthday, Brittany. While we wait for our fight, everybody say happy birthday, Brittany! Good job. Happy birthday, Brittany. Really? Happy birthday, sunshine. Happy birthday to Amy. Amy's blushing over there. I never noticed, Tom, that Benjamin has really nice dimples. Just saying. They're nice. I told you to wait in the truck. Kidding. Adam Martinez, are you ready for this bad boy? Ladies and gentlemen, Judge Joe Garcia scores the bout 29-28, Young. Judge Joe Lewanson scores the bout 29-28, Kimball. Judge Eric Hines scores about 29-28 for your winner in this split decision, Jeremy Kimball.
All right. I mean, that was an awesome fight from start to finish. I heard your corner telling you not to get carried away with flying jump kicks. What were you thinking in that first round? Were you just thinking, I'm going to end it with one of these?
No, I just thought he hit really hard, and I didn't want to go three rounds with him.
All right. You got tagged twice. Were you in trouble?
Yeah, but he let me recover. You know, we all make mistakes. He's a great fighter. And I won because this is my hometown. If he wants to do it again, let's do it again, baby.
All right, do you have any sponsors you want to give a shout out to?
No, I want to thank the Lord, Jesus Christ. I did this all for him, the weight cut, everything. And Team Wild Man, Thomas Denny, my dad, Kelly, all of Team Shingatai, Tambora Jail, everybody. Prince Ingram, thank you all for coming. I love you all, thank you.
All right, so what are we going to do? Should we see that fight again? It's next Mini Rumble. I don't know, Buzz, what do you think?
Let's kick ass.